Very good evening, dear students. Today we shall be discussing, continuing our discussion on the chapter carbon and its compound. In our previous chapter or in our previous discussion, we have revealed many facts on carbon. We studied many things about carbon. We also learned about saturated and unsaturated carbon compounds. There is a special class of carbon compounds which is made up of only carbon and hydrogen. Those compounds are known as hydrocarbons. Now, there are three main families of hydrocarbons. These are alkanes, alkenes, and alkynes. Now, saturated hydrocarbons or saturated carbon compounds means here carbon will be having all single bonds and those bonds will be saturated with hydrogen. Whereas unsaturated carbon compounds means here carbon might be having a double bond or a triple bond. That means saturated carbon compounds have got all single bonds, and unsaturated, they will either have a double bond or a triple bond, which can further be broken down into single bond by accepting hydrogen atoms. And this is the reason why they are known as unsaturated hydrocarbons. And under saturated hydrocarbons, we have alkanes. And under unsaturated hydrocarbons, we have alkenes and alkynes. So basically, we have got three different class of hydrocarbons: alkanes, alkenes, and alkynes. Again, let me have a recap on what hydrocarbons are. Hydrocarbons, these are the special compounds of carbon which comprise of only hydrogen and carbon. That means the compounds which are only formed by the combination of carbon and hydrogen, they are known as hydrocarbons. So let's have a detailed discussion on alkanes, alkenes, and alkynes. Alkanes, alkenes, and then we have alkynes. Alkanes means these are the saturated hydrocarbons, and all the members of this alkane family can be represented by one single general formula. Not only alkanes, alkenes and alkynes also can be represented by only one general formula. And for alkanes, the general formula that we have is CnH2n+2, where n starts with, the value of n starts with 1. 1, 2, 3, and it goes on. In case of alkene, the general formula is CnH2n, where n, here n will begin with 2. 2, 3, 4, and it goes on. In case of alkynes, the general formula is CnH2n-2. Again, n begins from 2, 3, 4, and it goes on. Now, a very common question, it comes in the mind of every student, that in case of alkanes, n starts with 1, right? But in case of alkenes and alkynes, n starts with 2. Why it is so? Now, alkenes and alkynes, they are unsaturated hydrocarbons. And as I told you before itself, that unsaturated hydrocarbons, they either contain a double bond or a triple bond. So in order to insert a double or a triple bond, we need a minimum of 2 carbons. I shall be discussing about all this a bit later. Let us first have a detailed discussion on alkanes. The very first alkene or the simplest alkene is methane with n equals to 1. So when you will put n equals to 1 in this general formula, you will get a molecular formula as CH4. This is the first alkene, or this is the simplest alkene. Okay, and its name is methane. Now moving on to the next higher alkane, the value of N will be 2. Now if you put the value of 2, you will get a molecular formula as C2H6, and the name of this alkane is ethane. The third alkane is propane with N equals to 3. So if N equals to 3, the molecular formula becomes C3HH, and name of the alkane is propane. And next we have butane, the last one, because I cannot extend more, I cannot go down, but there are many more alkanes, okay. So with N equals to 4, the alkane will be butane, and its molecular formula will be C4H10. Its name is butane. Is that clear? So the first alkane is methane, ethane, propane, butane. Then if you want to know more, it's there in the book. Then we have pentane, hexane, heptane, octane, nonane, decane. So minimum decane, N equals to 10 up to decane, you have to learn them in a chronological order. We start with methane, then ethane, propane, butane, pentane, hexane, heptane, octane, nonane and decane. Till decane, it's mandatory to learn, okay. Now coming on to alkenes. The general formula for alkene, as I told you, is CnH2n with N equals to 2. So the simplest alkane will have a minimum of 2 carbons, that means C2H4, and its name is with 2 carbon, the name of the alkane is ethane, right. So when it comes to alkene, we will have to omit this A-N-E-N, and we need to introduce E-N-E. So from alkane to alkene, we only have to make a very small change, that is we will have to change A-N-E to E-N-E. So it will become ethene. Then, so it is ethene. Then moving on to the next higher alkene with N equals to 3, it will be, the molecular formula will be C3H6, and the name is propene. The alkane was propane and the alkene is propene, but the number of carbon is still the same. Only difference is the number of hydrogen. Where there is a difference in the number of hydrogen, I shall be explaining. Now next higher alkene, that means with N equals to 4, it will be C4H8, and the name is butene. The fifth one is C5H10, and the name is pentene. This is all about alkenes. Now moving on to alkynes. Alkynes general formula is CnH2n-2, and here again N starts with 2. So the first, sorry, I did a mistake, it will be 1, 2, 3. The first alkene is ethene. This is the first alkene. Second alkene is propene, and third alkene is butene, fourth alkene is pentene. Now in case of alkyne, there will be a triple bond, and the general formula is CnH2n-2. Let's write down the first alkyne with N equals to 2. So when N will be equals to 2, the formula will be C2H2, okay. And the name is ethyne. So again, it's very easy to remember from alkanes. When we will be converting alkane to alkynes, we only have to omit A and E, and we need to introduce Y and E, so that it becomes ethyne. It was ethane in case of alkane. When it was an alkene, its name was ethene. Now it is an alkyne, so its name is ethyne. Okay. Now moving on to the next higher alkyne, where N will be equals to 3. If N equals to 3, the formula is C3H4. Okay, C3H4, and its name is propyne. The next higher alkyne with N equals to 4 is C4H6. Okay, and its name is butyne. This is all about alkenes and alkynes. Alkenes, they comes under saturated hydrocarbons, whereas alkenes and alkynes, they comes under unsaturated hydrocarbons. Now let me draw the structure of ethyne for you. Ethene. Let me start with ethene, then ethyne. This is ethene. Ethene's molecular formula is C2H4. So its structural representation would be, there must be a double bond. So here is the double bond, and each carbon contains two hydrogens each. I told you in my previous class that carbon has got four hands, right? And all the four hands need to be satisfied. Here, if we look into this carbon is bonded with this carbon through a double bond. There is a double bond between these two carbon, and so two of its hands are being satisfied by making bond with each other. There is a double bond connection between them. So, two of their hands are being satisfied. Remaining two will be satisfied by hydrogen. So, each carbon has got two hydrogens. Now, what will happen if I feed it with more H2? With more H2 in presence of nickel, platinum or platinum catalyst, what will happen to the double bond? See, double bond means one bond will be stronger, the other bond is a bit weaker, which is known as pi bond, regarding what you will be learning in class 11. So when a double bond, if I feed this double bond with H2 in presence of a catalyst, and the catalyst is nickel catalyst, then the weaker bond among this double bond, it will be broken. So one of the bonds will be broken, making two hands of carbon free. So now what happens, out of this double bond, carbon has converted to single bond. From double bond to single bond, and here it has four hands, and all the four hands need to be satisfied. If it is bonded to one carbon with a single bond, that means there are three more hands which are vacant, and we have already two hydrogens to each carbon. The other hands, it will again get hydrogen from where we have supplied. We have supplied this compound with hydrogen. So it will get those hydrogen from this H2 molecule. Now this carbon has converted to all single bonds which are being bonded with hydrogen. Now it is saturated with hydrogen, right? As because more hydrogen can be added to a double bond, it is known as unsaturated. You remember the definition of saturated solution. Saturated solution means the maximum number of solutes which will be dissolved in a given amount of solvent. Here also it's exactly in that same way. Now here, when it has converted to ethane, now this is ethane. See how many carbons this molecule is having, C2, how many hydrogens, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the molecular formula of the product is C2H6, which is nothing but ethane. So here, if you want to feed this molecule again with hydrogen, there is no more bonds to be broken, so it will not accept hydrogen. So there won't be any reaction. The reaction stops here. No reaction. The reaction stops here. Okay. That means it is saturated with hydrogen. it is no more in urge of hydrogen. There is no more bonds which can be broken in this molecule. So it is completely saturated with hydrogen. That is, maximum number of hydrogen would be present here. This is the reason why they are known as unsaturated double bond or triple bond, are known as unsaturated hydrocarbons, whereas when a compound has all single bonds, they are known as saturated hydrocarbon. Now quickly let me show you about a triple bond. What happens to triple bond? So when there is two carbon, it represents ethane, and when ethane has got a triple bond, it becomes ethyne. Ethyne, and its molecular formula is C2H2. Ethyne means there will be a triple bond. The triple bond should be between two carbon atoms. C triple bond C. Now look the carbons very carefully. Three of its hands are being satisfied by making bond with each other. Three of their hands are being satisfied by making bond with each other. So there is remaining only one more hand. So for each carbon, only one more hands are free. So in those free hands, it will grip hydrogen. It has bonded with hydrogen. It has used those hands, free hands, in order to capture hydrogen. Now to this molecule, if you want to supply H2, what will happen? You have to supply H2 in presence of a catalyst, and the catalyst is nickel catalyst. So again, one of the bonds will break, but one after the other. One of the bonds among those triple bond will be broken, making one hands free for each carbons. There are two carbons, both the carbons now will have two free hands. So the bonds between these two carbons, it will be changed from a triple to a double, making two free hands to each carbons. Those two free hands will be bonded with two hydrogen atoms. Okay. Again, if you want to fit this double bond with hydrogen in presence of a catalyst, so it is again ready to accept those hydrogen, because it has got double bond. Again, one bond can be broken, so it's ready to accept those hydrogen. So again, one of the bonds will be broken and double bond will get converted to single bond, making three hands to each carbon free. So now both the carbons had got three hands free. Those three hands will be bonded with hydrogen. Now it has converted to ethane. As there is no more bonds which can be broken in ethane, it became saturated. You want to feed him with more hydrogen, he will say, no, I'm full. My stomach is full. I don't want to have more. This is the reason why ethane or any other alkane, they are known as saturated hydrocarbons, whereas alkene and alkyne are known as unsaturated hydrocarbons, as because they are double bond or triple bond can be broken and they can accept more hydrogens. I hope it is clear to all of you. So this is why they are known as alkene and alkyne are known as unsaturated hydrocarbons, and why alkanes are known as saturated hydrocarbons. The next topic that we are going to start is chain structure, branch structure, and ring structure of hydrocarbons. So, chain, branched, or ring form of hydrocarbon. Let me explain you with alkane first. Okay, now the first three alkanes, that is methane, ethane, and propane. Methane, the molecular formula is CH4. Its structural formula or structural representation, if you want to represent methane, its representation would be like this. This is how methane will look. Now the next higher alkane is ethane, that is C2H6, and its structural representation is something like this. Done. Moving on to the next higher alkane, that is propane. Molecular formula is C3H8, and it looks like this. Its structural formula is something like this. Okay. Now, this is the molecular formula. The upper ones are molecular formula. Molecular formula tells us how many carbons and how many hydrogens are there in that molecule, in that particular molecule, in that particular hydrocarbon. Hydrocarbon, as I told you, is a compound which comprises of only hydrogen and carbon. You can see there are only hydrogen and carbon present in methane, ethane and propane. Other than hydrogen and carbon, no other atoms are there. So, they are hydrocarbons, and the second one which I have represented, or which I am saying that this is the structural representation, this is the structural formula of these hydrocarbons. And if you want to give them a different structure, you cannot. This is the only structural representation of these three hydrocarbons. But what about butane? Butane has got more than, butane can be represented in more than one way, but it has only one molecular formula. You cannot change the molecular formula. The molecular formula tells me about what that molecule is. So, butane means it has to be C4H10, okay. So, but the if I want to give him different structural features or structural representation, which I can. This is what I am trying to explain. So, the molecular formula of butane is C4H10. This is the molecular formula. That means a molecule of butane has got 4 carbon atoms and 10 hydrogen atoms. Okay. Now, structurally, if I now let us have a look how it looks if I put them in a structure. When carbons will be arranged in a long chain, when they will be joining each other's hand to hand joins, how do it look? It looks like this. C4 in butane, butane has got only 4 carbons. So, 4 carbons, then each carbon has got 4 hands. Let us start with one of the terminal carbons. If I start from here, this carbon has got one bond satisfied by making a single bond with the adjacent carbon. So, it has got 3 more hands vacant or to be satisfied. So, it has got 3 more hands to be satisfied, which is not yet being satisfied. Moving on to the next, or the second carbon, its 2 of its hands are being satisfied by making bonds with its adjacent 2 carbon atoms. So, if 2 hands are being fulfilled, remaining 2 are there. These 2 bonds will be satisfied. Again, the same scenario for this carbon and the terminal carbon, 3 bonds to be satisfied. So, all these bonds which are not yet being satisfied, which needs to be satisfied, they will be satisfied with hydrogen. That means they will form bond with hydrogen atom. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, 10 hydrogens, 4 carbons, that means the molecular formula is C4H10, which is nothing but butane. So, this is one of the structural representations of butane. Butane can also be represented in a different way, in another way. Let us see how. If I want to make a branch, okay, here all the carbons, they were holding each other's hand, they made a chain. But in the next second representation, I want to make a branch. So, here one carbon will be joined. Okay. If one carbon is joining here, now let us satisfy all other hands of carbon. A carbon has got 4 hands. Let us start with the terminal carbons. So, terminal carbon, here one of its hands is being satisfied, remaining 3. It will be satisfied with 3 hydrogen atoms. For this carbon, same scenario, it will be having 3 hydrogen atoms. Again, this is a terminal carbon. It also has to be bonded with 3 hydrogen atoms in order to fulfill all its four hands. Now the middle carbon. Middle carbon already fulfilled its three of its hands by making bond with three carbon atoms. So there is remaining one which will be bonded with hydrogen. So what we can see is the first structure and the second structure is not matching, right? In the first structure, all the carbons are joining each other's hand. They have made a long chain. But in the second structure, there is a branching also, right? So this is the chain form, this is the branched form. But one very interesting thing is both of them have got the same molecular formula. We counted for the first one. Let's count for the second one. It has got how many carbons? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbons. How many hydrogens? 3 plus 3, 6. 6 plus 3, 9. 9 plus 1, 10. C4H10. Same molecular formula, but different structural formula or different structural representations. So they have got a special name, and that name is isomers. So butane has got two isomers. That means isomers means are those molecules which have got same molecular formula but different structural formula. Okay, so butane has got two isomers. Let me write down the definition for isomer. Isomers means molecules having, isomers are those molecules or molecules having same molecular formula. But different structural formulae are known as isomers. And the phenomenon is known as isomerization. Okay? So molecules having the same molecular formula but different structural formulae are known as isomers. So we have seen about butane, which has got two isomers. That means butane with the same molecular formula can be represented in two different ways. Same thing can be done with pentane, but before going to pentane, I need to tell you one thing. So there is a very important question from the exam point of view, that what is the minimum number of carbon atom from which isomerism starts, or from where isomers can be occur. So this is the butane. That means minimum 4 carbon atoms. With minimum 4 carbon atoms, isomerism starts. That means methane, ethane and propane, they don't have any isomers. They have only one molecular formula and one structural formula. But with butane, they have got same molecular formula but two different structural formulae. Okay, so this is a very important question. Keep in your mind, minimum there should be 4 carbons in order a molecule to have isomers. So let's see how many isomers do pentane have. Pentane. What is the molecular formula for pentane? It is C5H12. So the very first structure of pentane, here all the carbons will be arranged in a single chain. So 5 carbons, and the remaining hands will be satisfied with hydrogen. Terminal carbon, 3 free hands satisfied with 3 hydrogen atoms. The middle carbons, they have got 2 free hands. Those 2 free hands will be satisfied with 2 hydrogens. Again, terminal carbon, 3 hydrogen atom. So if you want to count how many hydrogens this particular molecule is having, you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 hydrogen atoms and a total 5 carbon atoms. Okay, done. So this is one of the structures. Now, what will happen if it starts having branching? So the second form is pentane. There must be 5 carbon atoms. This is known as a skeletal structure. Skeletal structure means when all the carbons are being shown. Now again, terminal carbons. There are 3 terminal carbons. Terminal carbons means there will be 3 free hands. Those 3 free hands will be bonded with 3 hydrogen atoms. And this carbon, it has got 2 bonded, 2 of its hands are being used up. There are 2 more free hands. Those 2 free hands will be bonded with 2 hydrogen atoms. And this carbon, it has got only 1 free hand. Now let us give hydrogen to this molecule. Let us satisfy all the bonds. So this is one structure for pentane. There is one more structure for pentane. This is only, there is only one branch for this pentane, right? The first structure does not have any branching. The second structure have got only one branch. Now let me draw the third structure here for you. It will be having 2 branch. If I consider this be a chain, it has got 2 branches, 2 terminal carbons. And terminal carbons means 3 hydrogens. If you want to count the number of hydrogens and number of carbons, you can. There are how many carbons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 carbons. And how many hydrogens? 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 3, 9, 9 plus 3, 12. 12 hydrogen atoms. So what is the molecular formula for pentane? It's C5H12. And all the structural formulae, in all the, how many structural formulae we got right now is 3, 1, 2, 3. So it's not necessary that a molecule will can have only 2 structural formula, it might have more than 2. If I give you the example of hexane, hexane will have more than 3. Pentane has got 3 structural representation. One more thing I would like to tell you, that this CH3 molecule, if I count from here, if I start from here, this CH3 molecule is being bonded to the second carbon. Now you might be thinking, if I shift this to the third carbon, that is this carbon, if I want to shift this to the third carbon, will there be a different structural formula? There won't be any different structural formula. It would represent this formula itself. That time we need to start our counting, or we need to start our journey from this carbon, from this terminal. Why it is so will be explained when I will be explaining you about the UPAC nomenclature. When I shall be teaching you how to name the different hydrocarbons. There I shall make this point clear. So for now you only have to keep in your mind that whether the methyl group, that is this CH3 group, is present at this carbon or to the adjacent carbon, it makes no difference. It still remain the same compound, same carbon, hydrocarbon. So for pentane, it has got 3 structural representations, and hence it has got 3 isomers. I hope it's clear to all of you. Now very quickly let me show you the how the different structural representations for hexane. This would be the last one, hexane. Hexane, its molecular formula is C6H14. So the first structural representation for hexane is, let me start from a bit middle, where all the carbon atoms are joined in a chain, 5, 6, and terminal carbons, 3. The carbons who are present in the middle, their 2 hands are free, which will be fulfilled with 2 hydrogen atoms. Again, this is a terminal carbon. It will get 3 more hydrogens. If you want to count the number of hydrogens, you can 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So 14 hydrogen atoms are there, and total there are 6 carbon atoms, right? So what is the molecular formula? It's C6H14, and C6H14 is nothing but the molecular formula for hexane. Now let's move on to the other structural representations of hexane. So the first branching, let me write this CH3 in this form, CH3 CH CH2 6. This is another structural formula for hexane. One more, again the same thing. If you want to replace this methyl group from here to there, it would represent the same molecule. So no difference actually. So it will be like this only. Let me put CH3 here, and if you want to put to the next second last carbon, there is no difference at all, both of them representing the same molecule. So the third is CH3 CH2 CH CH3 CH2 CH3. See here, methyl group, if I start from this carbon, methyl group is bonded to the second carbon, right? But here it is bonded to the third carbon. If you count from this side or from that side, it is let me rub and let me write down at the top, CH3 CH2 CH CH3 CH2 CH3 3 4 5 6. So if you count the count from here, this methyl group, this particular methyl group is coming at the third carbon, 1 2 3. If you count from that angle, from the right side, and again it is coming to the third carbon. Okay, so this is a different structure. 3 and 2 are different. In case of 2, the methyl group is present at the second carbon. In case of 3, methyl group is present at the third carbon. Now fourth representation, where methyl group will be present at top as well as bottom, this is a different carbon, right? Different structural representation. Can you form one more structural representation for the same compound? If you have doubt, let us have a count on the number of carbons and number of hydrogens. 1 2 3 4 5 6. 6 carbon atoms. Now hydrogen atoms, 3 plus 3 6 6 plus 3 9 9 plus 3 12 13 14 C6H14, which is hexane. Now we can have one more structural representation for hexane. How it is? CH3 CH3 CH CH3 CH3. So this is also another structural formula for hexane. Hexane means C6H14. So total how many? I don't think so it might would have more structural representation, only 5 is the maximum. So what is the number of isomers hexane can have? It can have 5 isomers. Okay, now the main thing which I started with chain, branch or ring form. This is the chain form. If you have noted down what I am teaching, you will be able to see that the very first structure, I started with the chain form of that hydrocarbon, of that particular hydrocarbon. I started with butane. In chain form of butane, all the 4 carbons, they were joining hand to hand to each other, and hence they have got a chain structure. Then I started pentane. Pentane also have got 5 carbon compounds in the same group, in the same chain, and here hexane also, and others, they comes under the branched form of hydrocarbon. So we learnt about chain and we learnt about branch. Now we need to learn about the ring form of hydrocarbon. In ring form of hydrocarbon, what happens? The terminal carbons, they will come close to each other, and they will again they form a bond. Apart from making bond with hydrogen, the terminal carbons will form bond with each other. So let's again start with butane. Again, for methane, ethane and propane, there is no ring form. No, propane has, sorry, propane has, but methane and ethane cannot have any ring structure. So let's start with propane. But here propane means CH3, CH2, CH3, right? The molecular formula for propane was C3H8, isn't it? So this is propane, but when it will get converted in a ring, it will be known as cyclopropane with two hydrogen less than what it was having in propane, because the terminal carbons, they need to make one of their hands free so that they can form a bond with each other. And in order to make their hands free, they need to leave one hydrogen, right? So cyclopropane or the ring form of propane would look like this. Three carbons, they are joined to each other. Now let's see how many more hydrogens can be fit on each carbon. Now each carbon, you can, if you have, can have a very close look into the molecule, you can see that each carbon, in each of the carbons, they have fulfilled their two hands by making bond with two carbon atoms. Now remaining are still two hands. For each carbon, there are two more hands which need to be satisfied, and those hands will be satisfied with hydrogen atoms. So, and its name, it is no more propane. Mind it, my dear students, this is no more propane. Propane is this one, C3H8. If you want to calculate the number of carbons and number of hydrogens for this molecule, it has got C3 and H, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 hydrogen. So it is no more propane, right? This is cyclopropane. So the ring form of hydrocarbon is cyclopropane. Now let's have a look on cyclobutane very quickly. Cyclo means there won't be any terminal carbons, all the carbons will be joined to each other. So this is cyclobutane. So what we learned in today's class is, we have learned why alkanes are known as saturated hydrocarbons, or why alkenes and alkynes are known as unsaturated hydrocarbons, and we learned very important point, isomerism or isomers. Isomers, molecules with the same molecular formula but different structural formulas, and in exam you might have to write down all the structural representations for a particular molecule. So the molecules which can be represented in two or more different structural formulae with the same molecular formula, they are known as isomers, and the phenomenon is known as isomerism. And what we learned? We learned the chains form of hydrocarbon, branch form of hydrocarbon, and the ring form of hydrocarbon. Now this one, what I talked today is all about alkanes, but the same things can be done with alkene and alkyne also. Let me quickly write for alkanes for you all. Let me start with butane. I started with butane for alkane. Now as there is shortage of time, let me start with butene. Butene, it's an alkene. You remember the general formula, CnH2n, right? So butene, what would be its molecular formula? C4H8. C4H8 is butene. So the branch form of butene is, sorry, the chain form of butene is like this. Now anywhere you put a double bond, it's not mandatory that you need to put the double bond in the terminals only. You can put it in the middle also. Let me put it in the middle. If I put it in the middle, then I need to see how many more hands are there for the carbon to be satisfied. The terminal carbons, it has got only one single bond with the adjacent carbon. So three more are there which will be bonded with three hydrogen atoms. So this is also a terminal carbon, And if I look into the inner carbons, this carbon, it has got this particular carbon, it has got three bonds bonded to each other. So it has got one more hand free. That free hand will be bonded with one hydrogen. Now calculate the number of carbons and hydrogens it is having. Four carbons. Now how many hydrogens? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 hydrogens. So the molecular formula is C4H8. So this is butene. This is the chain form of butene. Now branched form of butene. So this is the branched form of butene. The middle carbon, all its bonds, all its hands are being fulfilled with three carbons, carbon atoms. So how many hydrogens it is having? 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 2, 8, C4H8. So this is the chain form, this is the branched form. And about the cyclobutene, cyclobutene will be like this. Anywhere you put a double bond and then check whether all the hands of carbon is being fulfilled or not. If I look into this carbon, this particular carbon, three of its hands are being fulfilled with two carbon itself. Only one hand is free, so it has got one hydrogen. Here also it has got one hydrogen, but to this carbons, two of their hands are being fulfilled single bond. Two of their bonds hands are being fulfilled by making bond with two carbons. So two remaining, those two will be fulfilled by bonded with two hydrogen atoms, and its name will be cyclobutene. So this is all what we have learned in chain, branched or ring form of hydrocarbon in case of alkanes and in case of alkenes. But in case of, yeah, in case of alkanes and in case of alkenes. So that's all for today. I hope you will be going through what I have talked so far today. You go through the book properly, and most importantly, stay healthy, stay safe. Thank you very much.